Let's try that. Again. restart the game. Third and 7. That intercepted. Yes, that was. Hey, Liz. Okay, he's already got neatly sold the ball. Okay. Handoff, which is good. Quarter. Yep. First. Big loss there. Thank you. Yes. And 10. Didn't throw it. Darn you, Far. knocked his helmet off. Boom. should have been watching. Triple coverage. Oh, they were injured. Thank you. Where's my punt? There it is. Thought I had that block. So it won't let me pick anything different, so hope we're not onside kicking it. Doesn't look like it. Regular brown slot. That's in my pants. Hammered right at the line. They gonna take a timeout or not? Nope. Alright, we'll do this then. We'll just let the clock run down. Game's over. We'll be right back. Hopefully that's it. Didn't want to actually start this one. Not really wanting to do. Okay, so let's just go to reboot the CD-ROM. It says nothing was saved. That's fine. It should be saved, I would think. Let me see. First, we need to see if the game actually saved or not. That's kind of crappy. Alright, that way again. Okay. Alright, so sorry you had to wait until the end of the video to get any real commentary on this game at the moment. So, as you can see, I was playing Madden on, or not Madden, Joe Montana's Sega CD on the emulator on my computer. Instead of playing it off of my actual Sega CD. Hey, Andrew. So, that is also, I've owned the game since it came out. And never really ever gave it a chance. I tried it a few times, and I hated it. So that is the first time I've actually ever played out a full-fledged game. And I am trying to do this in season mode. And I'm going to play out the full season. And that is going to be part of a newer series I'm going to start doing here on Twitch. I'm going to take games that I never liked when I was younger from any unit. My Sega Master System, any of my Sega games I got, any of the Xbox games, anything like that. And I'm going to start playing those out and seeing if, now that I'm older, if my opinion has changed on those games. So, first impressions of Joe Montana for the Sega CD. Part of my impression has still not changed. The graphics are horrible. I never cared for the graphics in there compared to the Madden games. And one thing I could never figure out when I was trying to play this when I was younger was how come the game was so different from the Joe Montana Sports Talks games they were doing. I was expecting the Sega CD version to be similar to that, but with better commentary, better sound effects. The graphics didn't really have to be improved any, but it would have been nice to see improvements in the graphics, especially with the power of the Sega CD. I mean, it's sad when the Genesis, they did a better job on the Genesis versions of the games. But, that's the way it goes. So, that was my first full-fledged game. And how are my feelings about the game at that point? That actually was entertaining. I guess would be a word I could use there. I already knew how to do the passing in the game. Like I said, I have played it a little bit here and there, but I never played out a full game, so I do know how to pass the ball in the game. I knew selecting receiver ahead of time was the best idea. It's definitely not easy to cycle through them when you got to push the B button to cycle through and an A to pass to whoever you stop on. So, Excuse me. But, yeah, physically wise, gameplay wise, it wasn't terrible this time. That was actually pretty good. I mean, I was impressed with the opening play. You know, getting the fumble on the kickoff, that was impressive. And getting my score right there, going up 7-0. I was actually impressed, too, because I've never seen it in the game, even with the small little bits I played of it, where when I sacked the QB from them, that I actually popped the guy's helmet off. That was interesting, too. A lot of interceptions in the game. I have no clue in one spot where I know who the two Packer players were that they were showing. You know, number 4 is definitely Brett Favre. 84 back in that time was Javon Walker. I have no clue in one of my interceptions that I threw when Javon Walker was wide open and I threw it. He was following his route correctly. But unfortunately, the pass went way off to the left. I have no clue why that happened. But those are the kind of things in a football game that sometimes can make the game more fun. You know, maybe I was, you know, throwing off Brett Favre's back foot or something like that. And Favre was notorious for doing that kind of stuff when he was with the Pack. But he also made the game fun to watch. But, yeah, physically-wise, that was not bad. I have no complaints with it. I'm glad I put it on the emulator for saving purposes. Maybe I missed how to save it when I was firing up the game, because at least I can start from week 2 still, so that's good. So I will play that on the emulator over running it on my Sega CD, because my Sega CD still cannot save at all. I still have to replace the battery inside of it. But physically-wise, I hope you guys enjoyed this little bit. I hope you guys enjoyed the little bit of explanation at the end. So far, my impressions have gone from the game sucks to I can play this. This isn't too bad. So sometimes just going back and playing a game that you despised before, maybe realizing, you know, you have to be in a different mindset. I was expecting that to be more like the John Madden games that were out there, but better, or even the Joe Montana Sports Talk. Maybe that was the key. Just, you know, have to go in with a different mindset and actually try the game. So, other than that, I'm going to end this stream for now because it's been about an hour. It's about as long as I stream. I see it says I have nobody watching today, which is fine. Hopefully you guys watch this video all the way to the end for a little bit of commentary at the end, or just fast forward to it. And I'll watch a few minutes of the game and fast forward on in to the end to hear my commentary on what I thought of the game. And I will go back to the other football game I was playing, the one that people hate on the Saturn, which is NFL 97. You know, this is the game that I bought for May. Just want to bring this up again. It's in just a regular DVD case. It's not in the real one, so I'm going to have to order that. No instruction manual or anything. But I was reading the back of this case. And I'm like, you know, these aren't the right graphics if you can see that. That's not the way the game looks. Then it dawned on me. The back piece they got here that the person printed, that's actually Madden NFL 97 for the Saturn. That's funny. They got the correct front part, but not the back half. That's kind of funny. Oh, and the other thing that I was having a problem with in the beginning of the stream. I have two of these controllers right here, which they're both now charging up. They are Retrobit Bluetooth Sega Genesis controllers. They work great on a Genesis. They are 8 buttons, so you can use them with the Saturn emulator, which is cool. The thing was that it hooked up fine. Oh, and they also have rumble pads in them, in case you were ever wondering. They actually have rumble pads in them. It hooked up fine to start with, but I'm guessing the battery was dead and just kept dying. So, the batteries are definitely the weakest link in these controllers. So, I switched over to a different Retrobit controller that I got, and that's this one. The Street Fighter II Retrobit controller, which I just made it sound like I'm putting Retrobit in for a plug-in here. This I bought, saw it on their website, Street Fighter II Retrobit controller for the Sega Genesis. It is only a 6-button controller with the mode button up on top, so it is designed for that. It has a dual hookup on there, so I can run it from the Genesis, or I can plug it into the PC. So I plugged that one in, and that actually, I like that. I wish they would do some more, like an X-Men one or something. That'd be freaking killer, but Yeah, that one, the Retrobit Street Fighter one, I think only cost me like, what, in between $10 to $20. Got it off of, not eBay, off of Amazon. So other than that, like I said, I'm going to end the stream for now. You guys have a great day. I will try to be back on again a little bit later today after we get done with where we're going. My mother-in-law is playing her bass in a concert thing. I don't know if it's like an Easter one that's a little late or something like that. She did this a couple years ago too. It's being held at a church out here. The church choir does all the singing. They got the church band playing behind it. My mother-in-law plays there too. She's a damn good bassist. Amazing for the fact that she is, I think, 75 now. And she plays one of the really big, tall stand-up basses. So, she's really good at it. So, other than that, once again, these are like your Midwest goodbyes. See you guys on my next stream. I am going to try setting up the streams, by the way, to be, you know, these days I'll play more of the retro games. These days I'll play more of either Xbox Series X or PC. So that would try to get a little bit more of a structure on into it. But my main goal still for streaming is whenever I play a game, I'm going to pop online to show you. So other than that, have a good one, and we will see you guys later.